As many of you know from my lab tour, I'm a big fan of using multi-divider bins to hold all sorts of electronics and mechanical components. While these bins are great, sometimes you end up losing a divider or buy a bin that doesn't even have enough dividers for all of your parts. In today's video, we're going to be creating additional dividers for this Plano 3600 bin. And now I don't have these dividers here. I don't honestly remember if it didn't come with them or I lost it. So what we're going to do is we're going to measure the existing divider and then 3D print our own additional dividers here that we can add additional compartments. This one here I use for storing small screws. And a quick little tip for you, I found that Scotch tape and a thin point Sharpie is a great way to label it so it doesn't rub off like these old Sharpie labels. Today's video is sponsored by my company, Impossible Incorporated LLC, where we do custom engineering design, robotics, and prototyping. If you have a project you need help with, please shoot me an email and we'll see how we can work together. All of your subscriptions and buying things using the Amazon links below, along with subscribing on Patreon, helps me with my work to develop snake-like robots like this, and then release videos like the one you're watching today, where I teach you about different things I've learned along the way. And with that, let's get started with today's project. Now, a good first step is to try searching something like Thingiverse to see if they actually have dividers for your system. So here's the Plano 3600, and we have this user, Jimmy James number 8, who went through and took a bunch of time and effort to create the divider. And I honestly forgot to search before I started making this video, but this is a good thing to do. Now, the way I'm going to show you how to do it is quick and dirty, and it's just designed to get it done. You can use these same steps for any bin, and it's just a good exercise if you want to learn CAD and practice your 3D printing. So we're going to go ahead and measure our own bin dividers and create our own design. To get started, we need a digital caliper like this and our divider. Now my goal is I want to be able to print it flat rather than standing up so I get better bed adhesion. If we look at the shape of the divider, it's got kind of an hourglass like this, and then it's symmetrical about the center into another side of the hourglass like that. So we need to know our critical dimensions of these areas here, along with our overall size. So we're gonna take our caliper out and we're gonna take our measurements, and then we'll go from there into Fusion 360 to draw it up so we can print it. I'm gonna be using millimeters for my units because I like to think in the metric system because we define our printing parameters in millimeters. With our measurements complete, we can now head over to Fusion 360. Full disclosure, I'm a SolidWorks guy working to learn Fusion 360, so it's gonna be a quick time lapse of me doing Fusion, trying my best, kind of guessing through. This is pretty much the first thing I've ever done in Fusion, and I haven't really gone through the tutorials. So bear with me, but at the end, we'll have something that we can actually 3D print. Here's the completed Fusion 360 model. You'll notice that I kept the angles of the hourglass shape, but I cut it off right here, and that's to account for the fact that the thinnest thing a nozzle can print is about 0.4 millimeters wide. And then I also made it so that the bin spacer is a little bit wider, and we have this whole flat surface here between the edge and the tip here, so we can print in layers going up. The next thing we need to do is then export it as an STL so we could bring it into the slicer software and send it to the printer. All we need to do is to go make, 3D print, select our body, and we can keep our mesh refinement where it is, hit OK, and then we could save it as an STL file. Once in slicer, I import the STL file and then rotate it so the face is flat. I'm using a fill density of 30% PLA and a print setting of 0.1 millimeters per layer. I want to check after slicing to make sure that our first layer is actually touching the build surface, and then we go on up. Once we're happy with this, we can then send it to our printer where we're running Octoprint, and it'll start printing automatically. Then we're going to use our time-lapse system, and we can actually see the print as it pops off the printer. If you want to create cool time lapses like this one, click the card up top, which will take you to the video on how I set up the camera on my Prusa printer. It's just that simple, and now we have all the dividers we could ever need for our bin. Taking a look at the completed divider, we could see that we have that hourglass shape that mimics the original one. It gets thin where it needs to, and then maintains its thickness to make it easy to print. We can go ahead and install our new dividers just like the old ones. They slide in nice and simply. Now, they're not super tight, and again, some people online spent a lot of time getting it to fit just right. But that's okay, because I find on these smaller bins, especially with these screws, I like to put a little bit of hot glue right along the edge here to keep it from lifting up, because it's a real pain in the butt when you have really tiny things to have to resort them if they slide underneath. So I'll show you how that process goes, and then we'll look at the project at the end. So there we have it, one completed bin with all of our organizers. The little bit of hot glue keeps some from lifting out. And it's things like this that with some spare filament, only maybe a dollar's worth at most, and a 3D printer, we can add value to something we already own. I hoped you enjoyed this video and tutorial. I uploaded the Fusion file along with the STL file to Thingiverse, and I'll put a link in the description to that, along with a link to the calipers on Amazon and the bin. Please follow those links. Again, if you buy anything on Amazon, I get a little cut. If you enjoyed this, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel so you can stay up to date on my whole series of projects in robotics and making random things. You can also learn more about me at my website, mattbilski.com. Thanks again for your time. Let me know how it works for you, and I hope to hear from you soon.